One of the most exciting things about Deno 2 is its fully backwards compatibility with Node and NPM. Thanks to this little detail, you can use Deno with any of your preferred JavaScript frameworks to build your products. On top of that, you'll enjoy both a modern, seamless dev experience and the best performance possible. To see this in action, let's build a web app with Deno and one of the most innovative web frameworks launched in recent years. Qwik is a JavaScript framework that delivers instant loading web applications by leveraging resumability instead of hydration. Resumability is Qwik's standout feature, enabling the framework to avoid reloading or rehydrating the entire app on the client side. Instead, it preserves the app's state while navigating between app pages and continues execution right where it left off. This means less JavaScript is sent to the browser, leading to lightning-fast page loads and interactions. Let's start by creating a new project using the Deno init command. This will run you through the setup process for Qwik and Qwik City. Let's choose the simplest empty app deployment with NPM dependencies. Quick side note, Qwik City is Qwik's built-in router and meta framework designed to handle complex routing and state management while maintaining the framework's blazing fast performance. With the setup complete, we'll end up with this project structure. Most of this is boilerplate configuration that we won't touch. However, there are a few of the important files to know when working with Qwik. The router head file manages HTML head elements like title, meta tags, and so on across different routes in your Qwik application. Index.tsx is the main entry point and homepage of your application that users see when they visit the root URL. Layout.tsx defines the common layout structure that wraps around pages, allowing you to maintain consistent UI elements like headers and footers. Finally, root.tsx is the component that serves as the application's shell, containing global providers and the main routing structure. With the basics out of the way, let's jump to the fun part, coding. Our app will display a list of dinosaurs. When you click on one, it'll take you to a dinosaur page with more details. We'll add our dinosaur entries in the dinosaurs.json file under the data directory. Our app will pull data from a file, but, of course, in a real-world project, data management is handled by a database. Pro tip, Deno has amazing support for ORMs as well. It also comes with TypeScript support out of the box, and we'll add our type definitions in the types.ts file. Qwik City offers support for API routes, which can be used by UI components to communicate with the server. Let's create a new file under routes API dinosaurs, which will match the incoming HTTP requests at this URL. Inside this file, we'll export a non-get request handler. When accessed, the data is simply imported from the disk and sent as a JSON response using the 200 success code. Following the same example, we'll define a dynamic route that uses the URL path variable. The parameter is passed in the handler and we'll use it to find the entry in the dinosaurs list. Of course, the handler will return the requested data if it exists, or a 404 error if no dinosaurs were found. We can start the server and access these URLs from the browser to get the actual raw data. Now that the backend API is wired up and serving data, let's create the index and the dinosaur detail pages. Qwik components have a similar look and feel as React components with a couple of caveats. The most important difference is that we'll use the special component function to define a resumable component. This is a key part of Qwik's unique architecture designed to optimize performance by minimizing the amount of JavaScript sent to the browser. Note that the dollar sign indicates that the component is lazy loaded. The framework analyzes the application, identifies parts that can be deferred, and only loads the JavaScript for those parts when they are needed. The root loader function allows us to fetch and prepare data on both the server and client sides before rendering a route. This data can be then used inside the component. We'll iterate over the dinosaurs and render a list of dynamic links. Now that we have our main index page, let's add a page for the individual dinosaur information. The component uses the same SSR pattern as our index page, but with parameter-based data loading and a simpler display layout for individual dinosaur details. Finally, we can see the results by running the Deno dev task. Now, you can build and run a Qwik JS app with Deno, and you have a good foundation to extend your app with more functionality and database support. You can also explore some of the other great features our platform is offering. Until next time, thank you for watching!